It's an X Factor double bill as the judges take their remaining contestants to their homes.
Bring it all to Dublin.
I'm going to invite all of you to Spain.
It's going to be my house in Beverly Hills.
Oh my God!
There will be one final challenge. One final decision.
Regrettably, it's going to be a no because he's not ready for it.
And the final four acts in each category will be revealed.
You're through.
You'll be one of my four.
You're through.
You are through.
Welcome to the X Factor. This is it. Tonight, you'll find out who the X Factor final 12 will be.
After months of auditions, the final seven contestants in each category are travelling to their judges' houses for two of the most important days of their lives.
The word shock just does not come close.
Simon's category are heading to his holiday home in Spain. Louis Bunch are going to his hometown of Dublin. And Sharon Seven are jetting off to Hollywood. For each of them, this is make or break. In just 2 days, the seven in each category will become four.
It's going to be difficult. I mean, now the real pressure kicks in because everyone's at the stage where they either do what they have to do or they go home.
First to arrive at their judge's home are the groups, who are being mentored by Simon.
I actually think one of these groups will win the competition. That's how confident I feel now.
Seeing something like this makes you want it even more.
Is it all his?
Wait, how cool is this?
Shut up!
Look at the pool!
This is probably the most nerve-wracking day for us so far. The more you go on, the more you so badly want it.
We're here, Simon!
We're here now!
Open up the door!
This means nothing if we're not through, so... Let's just keep focused on what we need to do.
It's going
to
be difficult. A lot of waiting around. It's hot.
We're just too close now. It's there. We're too close to let it slip by.
I wouldn't want to be doing what they're going to be doing.
Next to touchdown in Ireland are the 16 to 24s who are being mentored by Louis.
Seven people come to Dublin. Four of them are going to get on the TV. And the other three are obviously going to be very disappointed. And it's going to be a very hard choice for us.
Hello. This is when you start to realise that you're involved in something quite big. This is it now. This is my time to show them what I can do.
It's where it really begins. It's where the whole competition sort of kicks in place.
I am looking for the X Factor, and I still think that the winner is probably in my category.
And finally, the 25 and overs turn up at Sharon's Beverly Hills mansion.
Oh my God.
Hello! Oh my God!
It's Chico
time!
Wow.
Here we go.
I'm feeling slightly nervous because, you know, you don't know what to expect.
You know, my decisions can alter somebody's life, so it's a huge responsibility.
It's quite nerve-wracking. Very nerve-wracking, actually. I'm not going to lie, it's very nerve-wracking.
Me, personally, right now, I think I have a winner.
This is kind of hopefully where I'll shine. Hopefully.
Still to come.
It could be train wreck television, and I am going to look stupid.
I've just kind of blown it, really.
Still to come on The X Factor.
I was just like...
She's our number four. That's it. We're done.
Welcome back to The X Factor.
Earlier, Sharon's top seven arrived in Hollywood, home of the stars and the place where dreams really do come true. Tonight, they'll go head-to-head and perform at Sharon's £11 million mansion, fighting it out for a place in her final four. They all have one chance and one song to make a lasting impression. But before they perform, she wants them to lay down some tracks in Ozzy's recording studio. Helping Sharon out in the studio are vocal coach Mark, husband Ozzy, and PR guru Gary.
They're all great, man. I mean, you're going to be singing it live anyway. This is for the track.
So Sharon's final seven have been into the studio, they've recorded their tracks, and now they're going to perform live in her back garden in front of a specially invited audience of her Hollywood neighbours. And first up is 30-year-old Maria. The last time she auditioned, she was just days away from getting married to her fiancé, Lawrence.
I got married on Saturday and it was amazing. It was a proper fairy tale experience. Lovely.
Although the wedding went without a hitch, Maria then found out that her honeymoon clashed with her final audition in Hollywood.
Sharon wants us to come to her house in Beverly Hills. I basically lost the honeymoon because I just had to be here today. Thank you so much.
I tried my best, and that's all you can do.
I think she's the real deal.
What do you think they'll be saying?
I really don't know. I don't know.
What do you want them to be saying?
I want them to say she's great, just put her through, get her in the top four, she can represent for the over 25s. That's what I want them to be saying.
Maybe the song was too much for her too soon.
I think the song was too big.
Good luck. Thank you.
Thank you, Rui. Well done. Next up is 26-year-old warehouse worker Richie.
When I went to the audition originally, I never imagined standing here with Sharon and Ozzy's garden. Like, you know, it's just surreal. Like, it really is. Is it getting better? Do you feel the same? It's definitely a different world to what I'm used to and where I come from. But it's definitely one I'd love to be a part of. Definitely. You say one love, you get to share it. Leave your bed if you don't care for it. One love, one love, one love.
Thanks very much.
I nailed that bad boy.
I like him. I know that he would be a dark horse, but I think he's a good dark horse.
He surprised me, actually, with his performance.
It was the most enjoyable performance I've ever had, ever.
Someone who's not feeling as confident as Richie is 25-year-old Haifa. At her last audition, nerves really got the better of her.
I was really heartbroken, to be honest. I've been given a second chance, so I feel utterly blessed and really, really lucky to be here. I just want to really do my best. And if I do my best, whatever happens, I'll be fine. You know your love.
I was worried today in the studio about that one note. Keep
on. And she couldn't hit it.
And she still didn't do it.
No, I'm on the fence.
Again, we will see.
Whilst everyone takes a quick break, 40-year-old bin man and dad of two, Andy, gets ready for his performance.
What were you doing 48 hours ago?
Let me think. Bins?
This is another life, isn't
it? It is another life.
It's another way of living.
Sunset Boulevard.
But I know full well that a bad performance will send me packing straight back. It can be taken away from me just like that.
And with the break over, it's Andy's turn in the spotlight.
I said you're more, pretty little one that I adore. You're the only girl my heart beats for. How I wish that you were mine. La, 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 la.
I hope it was enough and they liked what they heard. I really want to go through and I really want this to happen for me and my family.
Next up, preparing for her last chance, is 36-year-old mum of two, Brenda.
It's such a big thing, the X Factor coming about, particularly for the over-30s, really. It is a serious golden opportunity for me, and I'm going to grab it by the horns and run with it. I intend on doing so. In these heels.
I just want to make love.
Whilst Brenda seems pleased, the reality is that for three of the 25 and overs, this will be their final X Factor performance, and emotions are running high.
Why are you crying?
I haven't thought about what will happen if I don't get through, but obviously, if I don't get through, I know I'm going to be crying a lot.
You want to go home with good news?
Oh, don't cry.
Up next is 26-year-old mum of one, Joanne, and she's desperate to be one of Sharon's final four.
My goal was to get to final seven, you know, and I'm here, and I feel on top of the world. But now I am here, it's like, give me a bit more, please, just give me that little bit more. I would just love it, you know, for me, for the family, for my friends, for, you know, speechless, I'd love it.
Oceans apart, day after day, and I slowly go insane.
How does this compare to your everyday life back home?
Let me just explain my daily routine, right? I wake up in the morning, get my son up, and I feed him, and then I dress him, and then I dress myself, and then I do my housework, and then I make my Steve's tea, comes on from work, and then we sit and watch telly, and then we go to bed. How does it compare, Kate?
Christ almighty.
All you can do. I enjoyed it. I can go away from this competition if I don't get through and say, you know, I did my best. And that's all I can give.
The final person to perform is 34-year-old ex-goat herder, Chico.
Welcome to Hollywood!
In the previous rounds, things haven't always gone to plan. At Chico's first audition, Simon walked off set when Sharon put him through.
Yes.
Thank you, Sharon.
You're pathetic.
Then at boot camp, he forgot the words to his song.
You know I'm a superstar, and I've traveled so...
So today, Sharon's expecting him to pull something really special out of the bag.
Everything is resting on my shoulders today.
My name is Chico, a.k.a. Chico Loco.
This is my time, and this time, it's Chico time. It's Chico time.
Like cats in the rhythm of God. I feel
I was just like...
That was probably the most entertaining hour I probably spent in LA in a long time.
The guy jumps in a swimming pool. He must be desperate for success. Because I've been doing this 35 years, 36 years. I wouldn't jump in water with a f***ing live mic. No way.
So now that Sharon and her team have seen all seven performances, this is where the hard work really begins for them. They'll deliberate into the night, deciding which three singers to send home and which four singers will take centre stage at next week's live show. Okay, guys, this is it.
I tried to give it my best shot, so I feel proud of myself. You never know how much you want it till it really happens, you know?
I'm just going to basically leave it up to God now. What will be, will be. If this is for me, it will happen.
She looks incredible. She's very bubbly, very pretty. But she struggles. I think it was the wrong song today.
I think she definitely has the X factor. I see her at the finish line.
She's got a complete package. So I think that she should be one of our four.
I'm doing it for my kids, my wife, and for all the ordinary guys that have a dream.
I've never gotten this close. It would just mean so much to me.
I gave it my all, and there is nothing more that I could possibly give. And if I'm not good enough, then I'm obviously not the man for the job.
He's genuine and he's different. And I think that he is very entertaining.
I have to say, he sort of pulled it out of the hat.
Sometimes a long shot is the one that can come through.
For me, I think he's got the lot. He did himself proud. I think he's a front runner. He's there.
I would be proud to have him in my four.
The more you wait, the more you doubt, and that's the agonising part.
This means absolutely everything, and I just hope that I'm one of the lucky ones. I really do.
It's really hard with her. I do not know. All I know is that in the studio, listen to that voice. Mm. It's a perfect voice it for is. Recording.
She's yet to do a bad vocal performance.
Someone has to go, because we can't have five.
She will give a great performance every single week. I'm not so sure she will.
They can both go away and be proud of what they did. Unfortunately for us, we can only take one.
You can only take one of these.
She's our number four. That's it. We're done.
Still to come on The X Factor.
This is going to be the most important day of your lives.
See you later. Let myself down and everyone else.
Still to come.
It's going to be the next 2.5 minutes, which is going to determine our futures.
It could be train wreck television, and I am going to look stupid.
Welcome back to The X Factor. We're with Simon Cowell in Spain at his ginormous holiday home, and he has the group. So his job today is to cut them from seven down to just four.
With Simon yet to make an appearance, the groups decide to make the most of their surroundings. Some of the groups unwind in the pool, others decide to go and explore the rest of the grounds.
As soon as we walked in here, it was like breathtaking, and then it just made you think, imagine if we like got so far into this competition that we could actually like own somewhere like this.
Well, there's one man who knows exactly how that feels.
Now they come here, they can sort of feel it, touch it, and it can all be taken away at the last moment.
As ever, Simon's joined by his experts, vocal coach David and former pop star Sunita.
This is going to be the most important day of your lives. I am completely open-minded at this stage. I haven't made one decision yet as to who's going through. But at the end of tomorrow, there will be four groups left, and three are going to go home.
Before the groups perform, Simon decides to speak to them one last time.
You've done well. If I'm being honest with you, there's been a kind of almost like a sense of desperation about you.
It's because you've got a golden ticket. It's not like we're going out to perform it and enjoy it like we normally would.
All the things that you work for.
Everything that we work for, you can hand it to us.
If the audience pick up on that desperation, it kind of puts people off.
Yeah.
Are you happy with the song?
I was pleased because it was a challenge, and we need a challenge to prove ourselves.
You did. Either you can manage it or you can't.
I see this as our only chance, really.
It probably is. Give me a little bit about your background, guys.
About 5 years ago, we moved to London, hoping to try and break it, you know. We were literally in the studio every day, just rehearsing, and we just ran up, like, a hell of a lot of debt, and basically, by the Christmas time, we sort of said, you know, how long do we give it?
And what will you do if you don't make it?
I don't know, I'd have to be picked back up again by family and...
Yeah. I've got to tell you, if it wasn't for your personalities, you know, you wouldn't have made it this far.
As we've practiced, it's got better, it's got a lot better.
If you can work this track out, then we're there. But if it's too big an obstacle, obviously it's going to be a no. I'm a bit worried about the image, guys, if I'm being honest with you. You're not a boy band.
Okay.
You are four talented singers, and that's what I want to hear today.
You know what we've got to do.
You nearly screwed it up, you know that. We put you under a little bit of pressure, and it all kind of fell apart.
Yes. When people hear us, they want to hear more.
If you screw up the lyrics again, I will not give you a second chance this time. There is an intensity about you which is over the top.
Okay, no, I understand that.
This is what every young guy in the world actually would love to do, you know? You're on a stage, you've got girls throwing themselves at you. You've got to start enjoying it. Because if you don't, trust me, the public won't.
With their final performances just moments away, the pressure is starting to mount. For all seven groups, this is the most important performance of their lives, and they know they'll have to deliver to secure a place in Simon's final four. First to perform are the brothers.
All the years that we've been working to get this far, it's going to be the next 2.5 minutes which is going to determine our futures.
What becomes of a broken hearted? Who has love that's now departed? I know I've got to find a kind of peace of mind. Help me, please.
That was just intense. It was such a blur.
I still think we've done all right. I think it's enough to go for.
Next to sing for their place in the final four, a fortune.
It's been an amazing journey, but you almost think after 10 years, you know, this could be one of our last opportunities.
I don't wanna talk about it, how you broke my heart.
How you broke my heart.
If I stay here just a little bit longer, if I stay here, won't you listen to my heart?
What do you think?
To be honest, I think we did well today.
Yeah.
I think we delivered really a good performance.
That was, I mean, if I could have hoped for anything out of everyone, I mean, we did what we came to do.
In the last round, fourth base forgot their words, so can they hold their nerve today?
It's our last chance now to sort of impress Simon.
Yeah, it's pressure now. Pressure's on, big style.
So excuse me for getting the things that I do. You said you were forgotten, whether they're green or they're blue. And you can tell everybody that this is your song. No one could ever take away.
Ooh, be quite simple, but ooh, ooh, my, ooh, my.
clouds I put down the earth. How wonderful life is. Now you're in the world.
Thank you.
Thank you.
For the week,
I just can't believe it.
Not again.
Just forgot the lyrics again. So
we keep hyping up the whole golden ticket thing. We hyped ourselves up too much, and like we cracked. End of story. We know in our heart of hearts we're going.
Next up are the Conway sisters, who, like fourth base, have struggled under pressure to remember their words.
So many emotions right now. It's unreal. Excited, nervous, happy.
We've been building for this moment the past, I'd say, 10 years at least.
All right, girls, in your own time.
You raise me up so I can stand on mountains. You raise me up to walk on stormy seas. I am strong when I am on your shoulders. You raise me up to more than I can be.
Okay. We've done our best.
We've done our best.
And we're happy with our performance, and that's all we can say.
It's up to fate, though.
Next up, our Eskimo Blonde.
I think this moment on this day is one of the most important days of our life, really.
And I need you now.
Thanks, girls.
It's very hard.
Yeah.
How do you think you sounded?
I don't know. I thought I was ridiculously bad then.
You weren't.
We've done our best that we could in the conditions. And have done no more for me.
After more than 8 years trying to make it, brothers Journey South are desperate for their big break.
We've always wanted it badly. And, like, I don't know, people say you can see it in our eyes, but, you know, we really do want it unbelievably.
OK.
Don't your feet get cold in the wintertime? The sky won't snow and the sun won't shine. It's hard to tell nighttime from the day. You're losing all your highs and lows. Ain't it funny how the feeling goes? Desperado.
Thank you.
It's just amazing.
There's a little crack in your voice. Are you feeling a bit emotional?
Yeah. Oh, yeah, I nearly cried at the end there. That was, it was just such a nice song. I was dying to sing it, you know. It was just an emotional time. It's good. Yeah, man. No problem.
Last to perform are Addictive Ladies.
All the groups here are so good, and their harmonies are on point. You know, it's not a game anymore. We need to go in there and deliver.
I never thought I'd see the time when you would be so far away from home, so far away from me.
It totally went. Everything just went. Don't know what it was. Why not for at all? At all, no.
So it's not gone well for Addictive Ladies. But with all the performances over, the fate of the groups is now out of their hands.
People don't realise how hard it is, especially the build-up waiting for it and everything.
This is like our last chance. It's now or never, isn't it? We need to get in the fourth.
going out at this stage last year, we thought we needed to come back and prove to people that we could do it.
We've been singing all our lives, and this is what our lives have been preparing us for this day.
Everybody wants them to do well, but
there's nowhere to go.
They work hard, they're focused, they love each other.
The song was too big for them today.
If you gave these guys a chance, I believe that they will work so hard to impress you.
He might let through two bands, two boy bands.
We have a major, major problem here.
They've become too perfect.
I think they're just so focused on what they're doing and, that, you know, they're lovely.
They are quite distinct. I just wish I'd met them 3 years ago.
Right now is the test to see where we're going in life, really.
We've got three confirmed. One place left.
Yep.
It's just not our day, Brett Phyllis. Do you know what I mean? Doug has his day. It's not our day.
They can actually do it. They fell down today, but they can work hard. This band is going to mean a lot of work.
Just bravery, you know, they have so much courage. And I think they're pop stars.
The potential, if I put that group through, is on the first week, it could be Trainwreck Television, and I am going to look stupid.
You always pull it off.
I don't always pull it off.
With Simon unable to decide on his final four, the group's agonising wait will continue until the morning.
Still to come.
We're down to the final four. They have to be absolutely brilliant.
He's a dark horse.
Just feel like I've let myself down and everyone else.
Still to come.
I thought I did all right, but I could have done better.
What's so funny?
No, I'm actually crying, Livia.
Really?
Oh, yeah, I just really like him.
Welcome back to The X Factor. We're in Louis's hometown, and it's from here that he's going to be holding court for the next 2 days. Yep, we're in Dublin.
And as always, Louis joined by his team, vocal coach Evie and stylist Faye.
Hi, everybody. Welcome to Dublin. I just want you all to realise it's probably the most important day of your lives. So give it 100%. I think the winner of the X Factor this year is in this room. I really do. Best of luck to everybody.
Louis's chosen a song for each of his remaining seven contestants that he thinks will challenge their vocal ability. And today, they have just one shot at performing it, one chance, and one song that could change their lives forever. First up to sing is 20-year-old shop assistant Shane.
Being in the final seven is just amazing. I mean, wouldn't have expected to get here. As far as I've come now is just beyond belief for me. I really want this. It's the biggest thing I've ever done. It can change my life, and all I want is just a better life.
Sometimes all I need is the air that I breathe and to love you. All I need is the air that I breathe, yes, to love you. All I need is the air that I breathe.
Well done. Thank you, Shane. Thank you very much.
I think I've done enough for myself. I'm happy now.
Yeah?
I've been doubting all day, but I'm happy now.
Next to have his last chance to impress Louis is 16-year-old James.
Hello, James. How are you?
It's been the best experience of my life, but it's also been really, really nerve-wracking. I'm just feeling really proud of myself that I've actually made it from 75,000 down to the final seven. So it's just such a good feeling.
Nothing's changed. Well, I'm a man of many wishes. Hope my premonition misses what I really feel. My eyes won't let me hide, 'cause they always start to cry. this time could mean goodbye, goodbye, goodbye.
Thank you very much, James.
That was really good.
Thanks very much.
What's so funny?
No, I'm actually crying, Livia.
Really?
Yeah, I just really like him.
I hope I did well. I really did. It just means so much. And, like, I just don't want to go home. I'll have to say that, oh, no, I didn't make it.
Also aged just 16, but determined to follow her dream, is Alexandra.
For my age, being young, I do believe in myself a lot. At the end of the day, it's my dream. It's my only ambition. It's all I want to do is sing. My granddad used to be a pastor, and that sort of led me into believing in God. Knowing that I've got my granddad, and obviously I've got the Lord right behind me, 100%, it feels good because I know that every step I go, I've got someone in spirit behind me.
I'm as pure and simple, born in a world where love survives. Now all men want her, cause life don't haunt her. I'm as you lucky, lucky thing. I'm as you lucky thing.
Thank you, Alexandra.
So, what do you think?
I done myself proud, you know. I gave it all and didn't give too much, just gave it the Alex factor.
The only other girl to make it to Lewis' last seven is 19-year-old office worker Chennai. Her X Factor journey began last year when she made it as far as boot camp.
This year, I'm definitely a lot more ready for it. I'm a lot more focused. I'm a lot more comfortable as a person than I was last year. I sort of do want to prove to everybody that I can do it. It's difficult when you know that you've got one performance, one chance, and to put everything that you have into that time is difficult. Hopefully, you know, it'll go well.
Off you go.
I'm still waiting. I'm still waiting. Oh, little girl, please don't wait for me. Wait patiently for love. Someday it will surely come. And I'm still waiting.
Thank you, Chennai.
Thank you.
I thought I did all right, but I could have done better.
Next to face Louis and the girls is 21-year-old student Philip.
Hey, Philip, how you doing?
Not very, not very good.
Good.
It hasn't sunk in yet that I'm here. Go to bed and thinking about it, you know, wake up in the mornings, and it's just not real, you know, it doesn't seem real, you know. I mean, being here, it just makes it hit you in the head, you know? It's hard to take in. If you've no idea what it means to me, because it's what I've always wanted to do.
Are you all set to sing?
I'm set as I'll ever be.
Okay, off you go.
Off we go.
Don't forget to remember me and the loves that used to be. I still remember you, I love you, but don't forget to remember me, my love.
Thanks, Philip. Thank you very much.
I'm okay.
Also hoping to make it to the final four is 17-year-old Nicholas.
Feeling very excited and proud of myself, feeling chuffed. Every happy emotion I'm feeling right about now. I do feel that I have what it takes to be in the final four, but whether I get there or not is a different story, but like, I hope I have.
My love, I'll never find the words, my love, to tell you how I feel, my love.
I can visualize myself doing this as a living, like, it's just, you know, when it's you and if you're ready and stuff, and yeah, this is me, it's what I want to do.
You made me feel brand new, for God blessed me with you. You made me feel brand new, I sing this song 'cause of you.
Thank you very much, Nicholas.
Thank you. This is it. I just have to wait now.
Last to sing for Louis, Faye and Evie is 16-year-old Trevor.
How are you?
I'm OK. I'm a little nervous, but...
Are you?
Yeah.
It's quite a lot to take in, this whole process, cos it's unimaginable. You don't ever picture anything like this. It's like you go to work, you stack shelves, and you expect that's how the rest of your life's going to be. So to be involved in all this is really... it's really nerve-wracking. Very scared.
Whenever you're ready.
This is the moment when all I've done, all of the dreaming, scheming and screaming becomes one. This is the day, just see it shine, when all that I've lived for becomes mine.
Thank you very much, Trevor.
That's bad, wasn't it?
Yeah, it was.
So Trevor's had his moment, but sadly, doesn't feel that he performed the song as well as he could have.
I said I wouldn't do this, you know. It's that knowing that you really wanted it and that you could have done it better. And I've just kind of blown it, really.
So that's it. All seven contestants have sung, and for three of them, that will have been their last X Factor performance. Now Louis and his team must decide which four of them will go on to represent him and sing live to the nation next week.
I like him.
He's not wow.
No, he's not at the moment. He could be.
To get put through to the four tomorrow would just mean everything to me.
We're down to the final four. They have to be absolutely brilliant.
He's a dark horse.
Just hoping that I get through.
I don't want you not to choose him because you don't think he can look right, because
no.
I know he can.
You feel that you've done your best and stuff like that, but your best may not be good enough to get in.
If we're looking for someone who's going to get votes, the public will vote for him.
You just get one chance to sing, one chance to impress. So it all comes down to you at the end of the day.
Just feel like I let myself down and everyone else.
I only want one girl in the final four. We have two here, I only want one. She's got a great attitude. She's got a passion.
I didn't think she was as outstanding as I thought she might be.
Do you think you have done enough? I won't say yes and I won't say no because you just never, never know.
This other girl is equally good.
She's better, but on the overall package,
Is she better?
I do think I've done enough to get into the final four.
Who do you want, Louis?
I don't know. I like both of them.
With Louis and his team unable to reach their final decision, all the remaining seven can do is hope and wait. And what they don't know is that wait will be a lot longer, because Louis decided to sleep on it and make his final decision in the morning.
In just 1 hour, the 21 remaining acts will become the final 12. For 9, the dream will be over. For the remaining 12, an exciting new journey begins. That's The X Factor, back at 8:10.